If you've never heard of IFERROR before, this is a function that tells Excel what to do if a formula or statement results in an error. The IFERROR function has two arguments: the cell reference or formula to evaluate, and the action to perform if it's an error. Here's how it works. To find out the unit cost of each item on this spreadsheet, we just divide the price by the number that comes in each crate. So, price divided by number in crate. Let's copy this to the other cells. And we have an error in row 3 because we divided by a 0, since there aren't any watermelons in stock. When we click on the trace error flag, it says divide by 0 error. So that's what this error type means. The IFERROR function allows us to state the value that Excel should return instead of displaying this error message. If we want Excel to display a text value, we'd type it within double quotes. So let's do that now. Let's get in front of our formula, type IFERROR, open parentheses. This is the value that we want to evaluate. And the value of error, we want to display nothing in this cell. So let's type double quotes with nothing inside and close parentheses. We'll copy this formula down by double clicking. And now this item where we have none in stock has no unit price. If the first argument doesn't result in an error, then Excel displays the result of the calculation as we see in these other cells. We can also give Excel an alternative calculation to perform if the first one results in an error. This spreadsheet adds employees' hours worked and their paid time off, then multiplies that by their hourly rate to get their monthly salary. This means that we'll get a value error for rows which contain text values, like we have here and here. So let's tell Excel that if this first calculation gives an error, it should multiply the value in column D by the one in column B only and skip column C. So let's do an IFERROR. Our first argument is this value that we want calculated. But if this results in an error, we want Excel to say multiply just paid hours off by hourly rate. Close parentheses and enter. And copy to the other cells. So now rows 3 and 5 are corrected. So the IFERROR function is really easy to use. It also allows us to create a friendlier experience, especially if the worksheet will be used by others. Let's look at this sheet where we can query product codes. If we enter a wrong code, let's see what happens. Well, we have an error message, NA. And what does NA mean? Let's click on the trace error flag. It says value not available error. That's not very clear, and so it's really not helpful. We can use IFERROR to return our own error message, which is more useful. Let's jump right in front of VLOOKUP with an IFERROR function. So our first argument is the value, which is the VLOOKUP function. But now, what if there's an error? Let's type product code not found within double quotes. Close parentheses and enter. Now remember that all error types will return the same message. So whether this was an NA, name, value, or any other error, we'd get the same response. And the truth is, seeing different types of error messages sometimes gives us a clue about what went wrong, meaning why we got an unexpected result. The NA error is usually associated with values not being found in a lookup array. But if we typed in a valid product code but mistakenly entered an equal sign in front of it, Excel gives a different error message. Let's see what happens. So let's type equals LSP. And if we only had our VLOOKUP, let's see what result we'd get here. Well, we also have a name error in our result. This is because equal signs are associated with functions and formulas. So Excel is looking for a function with this name. If it doesn't find one, it returns a name error. And this allows us to know right away what to do to fix the problem. We need to get rid of the equal sign. But if we used IFERROR to catch all errors, then we may end up barking up the wrong tree thinking that the product code itself is wrong. So if you want to catch NA errors only, you may want to consider using IFNA instead of IFERROR. It works the same way, but it only catches NA errors. So IFNA, value IFNA, product code not found. So let's go back, enter equals LSP, and we still get our name error because we use the IFNA function. We can also do a lookup in multiple ranges by being creative with IFERROR. Remember, IFERROR can tell Excel what to do if a lookup isn't successful, so we can just tell it to look somewhere else, like this. In this example, we want VLOOKUP to look up the value entered in cell H2 by searching two separate arrays. First, the A3 to B8 array, and then the D3 to E7 array. We already have it searching the first array, but this ID number, 6056, is found in the second array. So let's use IFERROR to search them both. We get in front of our VLOOKUP formula and type IFERROR, open parentheses, and we start with our first calculation. If that's an error, we want Excel to do another VLOOKUP. We're still searching for the same value, but now in this array. And we're looking in the second column, and we need an exact match. Close parentheses for the second VLOOKUP, and close parentheses for the IFERROR function. And we found our lookup value. Of course, it makes sense to create a value IFERROR if this also fails, because we could potentially enter an ID number that's not found in either array. So if we entered ID number 8111, that's not found anywhere, and maybe we do want an error message here. So here's how we do that. We'd also create an IFERROR to tell Excel what to do if the value still isn't found in the second array. So we type IFERROR, and maybe we want to see an error message. ID number, not found. Double quotes and close parentheses. Since we can nest up to 64 IF functions, and VLOOKUPs can be linked to data in other worksheets and even another open workbook, then we have a very powerful combination here. Ready to become an Excel ninja? Check out our self-paced courses at GoSkills.com.
Ready to learn more about Microsoft Excel? Then check out the full course on GoSkills.com. Click the link in the description.